This is 6th lecture series for CAT 17 slot 2, where I will be discussing questions from the CAT 17 mathematics and see how to go about approaching the questions. The focus is slot 2 because I wrote the paper in slot 2. Our basic idea is how to approach and how to understand a question. What I am trying to put across is whenever you solve a question, try to look at alternate ways of solving. When you try to do an alternate way of solving, you try to understand the sum better, and therefore you will be able to solve the sum in a much better way. So whenever you solve a sum, okay, in practice, don't be happy with one method. Try to look out for one more method or something. You may not get it. But the approach of looking out for alternate methods does help you to improve with regards to your concepts. So yeah, we'll take a few questions and try to see how to go about it. So yeah, how many 8 identical pens can be distributed? If you try to put a formula out here, it may take you a different tangent. It's actually very simple. So there are 8 pens and you already give 1 pen to Amal, 2 pens to Bimal and 3 pens to Kamal, because they have to get at least so many pens. So 6 pens are gone. What are left is 2 pens. Now these 2 pens, either you can give both the pens to one of the persons, which means that both pens can be given to either Amal, Bimal or Kamal, which will be 3 ways. Or you can give these 2 pens separately, 1 and 1, to 2 people, which means from that 3 you will pick up 2 and give them each 1 pen, which again becomes 3 ways. So total becomes 6 ways. How many 4 digit numbers which are divisible by 6? So when you say divisible by 6, the focus has to be 2 and 3. Now let's look at 3. For divisibility of 3, the sum of digits should be divisible by 3. If you look at sum of these digits is 15, which means for being divisible by 3, if you remove one number, it means you have to remove either 0 or 3 or 6. And second case is divisibility of 2, which means the last digit should be divisible by 2. So let's take each of these 3 cases and then go over it. Let's take if you remove 0. If we remove 0, what digits we are left with is 2, 3, 4 and 6. Okay, we know that the last digit has to be even number, so 3 ways. If one digit is gone in the end, the first digit can be also 3 ways. Second can be 2 ways and 1 way. The total number of ways becomes 18. Now if you remove 3, the digits left are 0, 2, 4, 6. All are even, so last digit can be any of these 4. To first digit can be 3 ways because 0 cannot be in the first digit. Second digit has to be 3 ways again because 0 is gone, so any remaining 3 digits can be second. 2 ways and 1 way. Again we get 18. And the last case is where we remove 6. So digits left are 0, 2, 3 and 4. Now there are 2 cases out here. Okay, we can take a case where last digit is 0. Okay, we can take a case where last digit is not 0. So if last digit is 0, then the first digit can be 3 ways, second digit can be 2 ways and third digit can be 1 way, which is 6 ways. 3 into 2, 6 ways. And last digit is not 0, which means the last digit can be either 2 or 4, 2 ways. Now 1 digit is gone and 0 cannot be first digit, so first digit can also be 2 ways, because first digit cannot be 0. And one digit is already gone to last place. To first digit is also 2 ways. Second digit also will be 2 ways because only 2 digits are left. And 1 way. So you will get total 8. So total number of ways becomes 50 ways. So here what we take is any number, that's what they say, an, is equal to thrice the sum of all the remaining numbers. Just for the sake of it, let me say the sum of all the remaining numbers is x. That means an will become 3x. Next we come to an plus 1, which is 3 into sum of all the remaining numbers, which is an plus the remaining numbers. We know an is 3x. Plus we know remaining numbers is x. So that means this becomes 12x. So if you keep on doing it, we realize that number is 3x, then previous number is 12x, the previous number becomes 48x, so the ratio is 4. The ratio is 1 by 4. The moment you get the ratio is 1 by 4, then there are two ways of solving it. Either you can go with the options and then try to solve it. For example, if I take the option say 3 upon 32 as the fifth number, first number will be 4 terms before. So when you are going reverse, here you are dividing by 4, so here you have to multiply by 4. So you have to multiply by 4 raised to 4 and solve. First term is 24, and then the sum of terms becomes a upon 1 minus r. Sum of an infinite geometric series is a upon 1 minus r, which is 24 upon 1 minus 1 upon 4, which will give you 32. Or you can solve by sum of an infinite geometric series is a upon 1 minus r, which is 32. I know r. R is 1 upon 4. So from that we will get a as 24. The moment you get a as 24, the fifth term, a5, will be 24 into 1 upon 4 raised to 4. Solve this, you will get 3 upon 32. C option. In this case, in an arithmetic progression, you always assume, we always should consider the middle number as an average. Okay, we start with when a number is given to us. The number given to us is 450. So this 450 is sum of 5 consecutive even numbers, and the middle number will be average. So average will be 450 upon 5, which will be 90. If average is 90, these are all even numbers, so next term will be 92, next term will be 94, so last term will be 94. If last term is 94, which is 283, which means we get A3 as 47. So 47 is the A3 middle term of the series of odd numbers. If this is 47, next term will be 49, and the last term which we want, A5, will be 51. The answer here will be 51. So property that has to be considered out here is that the middle number in an arithmetic progression, because the consecutive odd numbers or consecutive even numbers are in AP, the middle number will always be the average of the numbers. And the basic idea behind all these sums is to try to look at various approaches and solve. So here we have taken a couple of sums purely based on progression and permutation combination which came in CAT 17 slot 2, and looked at how to go about solving it. Simple techniques and understanding the sum will definitely help you to solve things better. So focus on trying to understand the sum rather than trying to just solve it. So every sum that you get in your practice, take some time, understand it, and then look at approaching to solve. I hope that helps. Thank you.